Feels like it's time, time for a change. Let go of the hatred, let go of the pain. I see a storm cloud coming, oh, bring on the rain. Feels like it's time, time for a change. This town, looking for something I haven't found. But when you don't feel right in your own skin, you gotta look deep down within. It feels like it's time, time for a change. It feels like it's time, time change. Let go of the hatred, let go of the pain. I see a storm cloud coming, oh, bring on the rain. It feels like it's time, time for a change. My best just to get along. But we got a responsibility on the shoulders of you, the shoulders of me. And don't you feel like it's time, time for a change? Mama, use your voice like it's time, time for a change. Let go of the hatred, let go of the pain. I see a storm cloud coming, oh, bring on the rain. It feels like it's time, time for a change. Yeah, it feels like it's time, time for a change. Let go of the hatred, let go of the pain. See a storm cloud coming, oh, bring on the rain. It feels like it's time, time for a change.
Welcome out to Live and Local. My name is JJ Voss. Good to be with you. This is for all my friends south of the border. I hope you guys are having a great night. Now there's a bag man with a black cat. He's living in a black neighborhood. He's got an interstate running through his front yard. You know he thinks he's got it so good. There's a woman in the kitchen. She's cleaning up evening slop. And it looks at her and says, hey, darling, I can never you could stop a ball. Oh, but ain't that America for you and me? Ain't that America something to see, baby? Ain't that America home of the free? Yeah. Little pink houses for you and me. Oh. Now there's a young man in a t-shirt. He's
listen to a rock and roll station. He's got a greasy hair, greasy smile. He says, Lord, this must be my destination. Girls told him when I was younger, they saying, boy, you're gonna be president. But just like everything else, those old crazy dreams just kinda came and went. Oh, but ain't that America for you and me? Ain't that America something to see, baby? Ain't that America home of the free? Yeah, little pink houses for you and me. Oh, they built them, baby, now for you and me. Help me out with this next part. Sing along at home. Out of Gulf of Mexico, oh yeah. Him is winners, him is losers, but that ain't no big deal, cause a simple man, baby, pays the bills, the thrills, the kills, that pill. Oh, that ain't that America, you and me. Ain't that America something to see, baby? Ain't that America, home of the free, yeah. Little pink houses for me, oh. Oh, but ain't that America for you and me? Ain't that America, yeah, something to see, baby. Ain't that America, home of the free?
Very much welcome out to Live and Local at a new location here at Brewed Awakenings on Dudeney Avenue in Regina. Thanks for joining us. It's been a hell of a few weeks. I want to reiterate to everybody across the 49th parallel, I wish you peace. I wish things settle down, and I hope you all just learn to get along with each other a little bit better, and we can probably do the same thing up here in Canada. So here's a song from 1988. It was first recorded in 1977, I believe, but it didn't get released, and it's one of my favorites. It's called The Devil's Right Hand.
About the time I did a lift to fight the big war, saw my first pistol in the general store. General store. I was 13, thought it was the finest thing I ever had seen. Sized the packet on Sunday when I grew up. And mama dropped a dozen eggs, she really blew up. She really blew up. I didn't understand. Mama said the pistol is the devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. Mama said the pistol is the devil's right hand. My very first pistol was a cabin ball Colt. She shoots as fast as lightning, but she loads a mite slow. She loads a mite slow. soon I found out it'll get you into trouble, but it can get you out. So then I went and bought myself a Colt 45, called a peacemaker, but I never knew why. I never knew why. I didn't understand. Mama said the pistol's the devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. Mama said the pistol is the devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. Mama said the pistol is the devil's right hand. Got into a card game in a company town. I caught a man cheating. I shot the dog down. I shot the dog down. I watched a man fall. Never touched his holster. Never had a chance to draw. Trial was in the morning and they drug me out of bed. They asked me how I pleaded. Not guilty, I said. Not guilty, I said. You got the wrong man. Nothing touched the trigger but the devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. Mama said the pistol is the devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. Nothing touched the trigger but the devil's right hand. But mama said the pistol is the devil's right hand.
Oh, righty then. Thank you. Hey, I hope you guys are all doing good. I hope you had a good couple of weeks since I last seen you. And for anybody who is joining us for the first time, thank you very much. I grew up north of a little town by the name of Cupar. It's about an hour north of Regina. I grew up on a small farm. And I've been at one time or one way or another throughout my life pretty much making a living playing music and in the entertainment industry since I was a kid. So I'm very fortunate to be able to keep doing this, and I thank you very much for being the reason why I'm able to keep doing this. Thanks for tuning in. I want to do this next song here for a very special little guy who's staying up probably past his bedtime. And I heard he has his guitar out and he's ready to go. So Lexan, if you're listening, I want to do this one for you. I want you to sing along. Make sure you're being good for your mom and dad. This song is about just learning how to get along with each other. It's called Some People. Well, some people stay. Some people head down the road. Some people rock, some people roll. Some people sing, some people just gotta dance. Some people play safe, some people take a chance. It takes all kinds to make this world go around. An open heart will never weigh you down. So do the best you can and be a better man. Just listen, try to understand that some people love, some people so full of hate. Some people say nothing, some people have a lot to say. Yep. Some roll straight down the middle. Some people will argue all day and all night about a violin or a fiddle. It takes all kinds to make this world go around. An
a better man. Just listen, try to understand that some people have faith, some people ain't got no hope. Some people pray, some don't, but some people stay. Some people head down the road. Some people rock, some people roll. Oh, you know, some people rock, some people roll.
Then. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, Lexan, it's time for you to go to bed. Be good for your parents. Anyhow, I have very special guests that are joining me. I'm very excited about this. I just met them probably for the first time maybe 2 years ago, and I've gotten to know them a little bit, and they've driven all the way in from North Portal to come join me tonight. So without further ado, let's bring up Last Birds. Come on in. I got to make some kind of rule about not dressing better than the host.
Oh, yeah.
We got to write that into the bylaws somewhere.
Well, you need a mom that's really a very talented person and makes you your own clothing. So thanks, Mom.
Well, my mom actually made me a lot of clothes, but that was a long time ago. Maybe I can get her to do that.
Yeah.
Mom, are you watching? She hates my hat.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she absolutely hates this old hat of mine. And she, every time I see her, she goes, "That was pretty good last night, but didn't you get a goddamn new hat already?"
Yeah. So maybe she can make you one.
Maybe. That's So how are you guys doing?
Good.
Really good. We're here. We made it.
Yes.
On the roads. They were a little icy.
Didn't blow away, so that's good.
Yeah. Well, thanks for making the trek in. I really appreciate that. And you're from, is it North Portal or Portal?
Well, North Portal. Because okay. There's a big difference, because there's that big boundary line. So if you're in Portal, you're in North Dakota.
Ooh.
Totally okay. Different country, zip code, yeah. The whole deal.
I'm glad I got it right then.
Yeah.
Because there was probably a gang from Portal that would have been showing up. And
yeah, they're called Border Patrol.
Yeah. Fair enough. Well, you guys have, for anybody who doesn't know of the Last Birds, from my recollection, or what I know of you guys so far, is you're husband and wife, and you've been married for how long?
13 years. Good years. 13 long, wonderful years. Yes.
Excuse me, I'm coughing. That's wonderful. Now, you guys, how long have you been playing music together?
Surprisingly, not 13 years. We didn't start playing until 2017?
Was it the last little bit of 2017, I think? We recorded an album with a friend of ours named Jeff.
Yeah.
And then we started writing some other songs. And then Lindsay picked up a guitar a couple of years ago. And
now she plays better than I do, and I've been playing this thing my whole life.
I hear you.
I don't know. I haven't performed yet tonight, so we might not be sure about that yet, but...
Well, so then you did an album as a trio,
right?
And then now you're doing this project as a duo.
Yep.
Excellent. And you've got one single out so far?
We have one single out. That's called Worry About It. That came out in October. And then we have another one coming out on January 22nd?
That's Friday.
That's Friday, yes.
Well, that's pretty awesome.
Yeah, we're glad to be here to be able to, you know, make some noise about it.
And then you got a record coming out in April.
That's right.
You guys are busy. You got showcases coming up.
Yeah.
You've got you guys were on Sastel Max, which
we've been doing as much as we can.
Well,
you know, and I think that's all you can do in this right now. But
given the situation, you guys are as busy as anybody, which is pretty impressive in itself. So.
Well, we were looking forward to playing with you at our concepts in Estevan a while back, and that didn't work out for obvious reasons. So we're so glad to be here with you tonight.
Well, I'm glad to have you. So I'll stop talking, and I'm going to let you guys sing a song.
All right. So the first one we're going to do is our first single, Worry About It. And there's, I think a lot of people have a lot of worries these days, but it's really important to have that one person or those people that are closest to you look out for you and you look out for them. This is Worry About It.
Across the hall, voices rising, criticizing, till a fist goes through a wall. Every morning I go to work wondering if today will be my last. First time off, last layoffs, hope to God I'm not harassed. I worry about it, I worry about it. I worry about it, I worry about it all.
My lover says,
don't worry about it, don't worry about it.
Song that's fit for the times.
Yeah. We wrote that song a couple of years ago, and it's amazing how relevant it became in the last little while.
What a great song. And yeah, I was thinking about this, and I don't know how to say this so that it doesn't sound insulting. So please, I hope you guys have a thick skin. You're in the music business. You have a thick skin.
Okay, here we go. Lay it on us, JJ.
Okay, you guys got this like family harmony, so you're not like brother and sister, right?
No.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, North Portal's small, but it's not that small.
We live in the sticks, but not that far.
No, but maybe it's when you get married. Maybe then that you pass that torch for the sibling, like for family harmonies, because you became family.
I think so. And I mean, because we've been together, married for 13 years, they say that you start copying your spouse's facial expressions and you start laughing the same way. So maybe our voices have also melded together in some way.
Well, it's in my backhanded, hillbilly sort of way, that was a genuine compliment.
Okay.
Thank you. We appreciate it.
We'll take it.
No, I love your harmonies are incredible.
Thank you.
What you guys got next? What are we doing?
Well, we thought we'd do the single that's coming out on Friday.
I'd love to hear it.
And this is a little tune called Wedding Day. And when we're writing songs, sometimes we work together in the same room at the same time. Sometimes, you know, one of us will be in another room and kind of working on a song, and then they bring it to the other person and we work on it then. But this is one that just really came together very quickly. Mm-hmm. Both of us in the same room, same time. The words came into play right away, and you know those are pretty magical moments, right?
When they
as
fall
a songwriter.
Out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So this song is actually based on a Victorian nursery rhyme that said you could tell how somebody's marriage was going to be by the color of the dress they wore on their wedding day. Because in Victorian times, you didn't necessarily wear a white dress. You might wear just whatever your Sunday best is.
Oh, okay.
So this is Wedding Day.
All right.
If you wore white, if you wore white, if you wore blue, love would be true. If you wore blue, if you wore blue. But you wore red, your wedding day. If you wore gray, travel far away. If you wore gray, if you wore gray. But you wore red, your wedding day. Woo!
People should wear red. I think more brides.
I think so too. Although, you know, no, I'm not going to tell you what the nursery rhyme says about someone who wears red on their wedding day.
Well, that was my next question. I was leading to that.
You'll have to Google it.
Well, so that song is coming out on Friday.
It is.
Where are people going to find that? How do we get a hold of that song and follow your music?
It's on every streaming platform you can think of. So Spotify, Apple Music, Amazon, Deezer, everything.
Everywhere. So. Well, where's your website?
Our website is easy. It's just lastbirds.com.
That's pretty easy.
Yeah.
Is there a story behind the Last Birds? Where's the name come from?
Well, I don't know if you can tell on the live stream, but if you like zoomed in really close, you might be able to see that there's quite a bit of white sort of coming in here. Too.
So we're not the early birds, if you get our drift.
Oh, yeah. I got you. Okay.
We also came to music as a couple late. Mm-hmm. So, you know, the early bird gets the worm, and there's always those birds that seem to be taking their sweet time flying south for the winter. You know, they seem to be hanging around a little too long, and you think, you better get going, you
fly
better get doing
fly.
Something, or else you'll never get there.
The last birds get the leftovers, and, you know, there might be a lot of good stuff left behind.
That's what we're banking on.
Well, that's a pretty, that's a great name. I sure like that. I'm going to maybe rename myself or something like that. Old Crow, maybe. Or...
There you go.
What you got for us next?
Okay.
Well, this next song is actually about, it's been inspired by a relative of Lindsay's. Okay. His name is Uncle Tom. And, well, why don't you talk about your Uncle Tom?
My Uncle Tom is a wonderful person. And if Tom, if you're watching, we love you. But he's one of those people that has uncanny bad luck. And I'm not just saying like a little bit of bad luck. Like he has, over the course of his life, lots of bad things happen. And that are... not his own fault, a lot of them, like his house burnt down because a building next to it caught on fire. It was an old building, took his house with it.
Buys a new car, drives it off the lot, and fender bender.
Of course.
You know.
Yeah.
But even though he's had all these challenges in his life, he still has a positive outlook. He's still a nice person. He's not bitter. So we really felt that Tom deserved to have a song written about all his... Troubles and toils over the years.
Awesome. I like that.
And he does it with a smile. He's the nicest guy I can meet.
Those people are special. I had a stretch or a few different eras of my life where it seemed like I had that same Flintstone cloud where the cloud was following my car.
Oh, right.
But they would be in, I don't know, maybe groupings of a few years at a time, but it seems to have leveled out. Yes. So to hear that somebody else, there's other people like that, it's awesome. I'm sure he loves the fact that you wrote a song for him.
Yeah, and it actually has a name, that kind of luck.
Okay.
When I was, you know, learning how the family works when I married Lindsay, that's some Tom luck there. I'm like, what? So it's actually a thing in the family, yeah. So
we're going to try and start it as an expression.
All right. And here's the things turning around for Tom.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right.
Maybe this song will do it for him. This is Tom Luck.
Some walk through this life under lucky stars, but you are one. Thank you. troubles you've seen. Oh, there's no heaven to blame, no curse burying your name. It's just dumb luck, 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 dumb luck.
Thank you.
That's for you, Tom.
Well, I think his luck is turning around. If you got a song written about it.
We might have to give him some songwriting credit, though, because he gave us all those little inspirations and stories to put into the song.
Have you played it for him?
I think that's the first time. This is the first time we've ever played it.
Is that right?
Yeah. So,
oh, cool.
If he's
so
watching.
It was a debut for Tom, then.
Yeah.
Well, awesome. I'm kind of losing track. Well, how many songs you got left?
Well, do we have time for two more?
Of course,
one
you
more?
Do. You can play the play for another hour. I love listening to you guys.
Well, kind of going along with, you know, Tom Luck, there's also just the fact that life doesn't always turn out the way you thought it was going to. Like, I'll tell you, I didn't know I'd be doing this when I was, you know, 18 years old. And this is a pretty good thing, but there's some things in your life that when you were 18 or in high school, you thought, well, when I'm, you know, in my 40s, this is where my life is going to be. And I don't know about you, JJ, but mine's not exactly where I thought it was going to be.
Sometimes life just gets in the way of your plans.
Yeah. So this next song is kind of about that phenomenon. How are we for two? Am I good? This is so simple.
Get your way. it will never be.
Thank you. That was one of the first songs that Lindsay ever wrote.
Is that right?
Yeah, and I fell in love with it instantly.
Oh, no kidding. Well, so who would you consider your biggest influences as writers and as artists?
Well, I know one for both of us is Gillian Welch.
Yeah.
Like, what a great storyteller. And
those Texas songwriters.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. She's just, yeah, she's a bit of a hero. We really liked what Robert Plant and Alison Krauss did with Raising Sand. Just two completely different people coming together to make a really special album.
Well, Mike, you were saying you played in different types of bands years back. In different genres of music.
Well, yeah, I played a lot of hard rock and things, but I mean, always when I was at home, the first guitar I would grab would be my acoustic.
Yeah.
And I didn't realize just how much I loved it more than anything else.
Right.
And I'm glad that, you know, in my room or when I was at home, I was playing acoustic all the time.
Right. Well, then just to reiterate, like, Lindsay, you've only been playing guitar now for, a year, and a half?
I'm just had my second anniversary.
2 years.
She's a good teacher.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it does make a difference when you have a live-in teacher.
Yeah.
Who can work with you every day and give you little tips. And I learned how to play piano as a kid, and it was you know, classic piano lessons where you go and you read the music and you try to play it exactly like the music is written. And I had a really great teacher, but it didn't really come that naturally to me. So even though I learned some valuable things about music and music theory, I always felt that I would have been able to play better if I had just learned to play chords or just sort of feel it. So
free form, less rules.
Yeah. So when I said, okay, I need to learn how to play guitar, I asked Mike to just show me the chords and I'm just going to try and figure it out. And I think I've found my way of approaching music.
There's something so freeing when you... my first instruments was... I played keyboards as well and was reading music, and I could do it, but I hated every minute of it. And when I picked up the guitar, it was just like having handcuffs taken off, where you could use your ear and find your way, feel your way through things, and it just made it fun for me.
Mm. Yeah. I totally agree with that.
Yeah. Well, great. Well, it's been an absolute pleasure having you guys on. I am very impressed with what you guys have accomplished so far, and I'm looking forward to following your career. It's you guys have got a lot of great stuff ahead. Coming up is... immediately, you guys have a performance this coming Sunday on SAS Music's award show.
Yeah, that's right. There's we're lucky to have one of our performances highlighted there. So we really appreciate SAS Music having us as part of the show.
We can find that where on the SAS Music page
is going to be broadcast. Yeah, I think they're streaming it from Facebook and YouTube. So.
Okay, well, so
we'll be seeing your face all over the awards there. I mean, you had such a great finish and the best albums. The year.
Well, thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you for that. Well, that goes out to everybody watching at home, because I think the albums were kind of ranked by fan voting.
Yeah.
So, you know, I got Tennille Arts got the album of the year, and I think I came in second place. So I got to have that goes out to everybody who's watching at home for supporting what I'm doing and going in and voting. Mm-hmm. And I think I'm nominated for Roots Artist of the Year as well. So yeah, we'll see where
we'll be cheering for you.
Well, thank you. We'll see what happens. I'm looking forward to your performance there. And again, your website is just lastbirds.com.
You got it.
It's pretty simple. Let's hear your last song. Thanks for joining me.
All right.
That's just how I. So this song is this is our newest song. We wrote this over the Christmas break.
I got home from work on the day before Christmas break, and by 8 o'clock,
here's the song.
Something happened. That's
so awesome. Hopefully we can play it well, because it's brand new.
Please. my lucky star.
Drive safe on the way home. Thanks again for joining me, and you stay in touch, all right?
Yeah, thanks so much for having us.
Yeah, you bet. Go check out their music, folks. Follow them on all the social media platforms and all the streaming platforms, however you consume your music. Go find them, The Last Birds. They played some pretty songs, so I'm was thinking I should probably try to pull out a song where I can pull it back and try to get pretty. So this one's off my current album. It's about there's a lot of songs written about looking for true love. This one's about finding it. It's called You and Me.
Till the end.
No, there ain't much in life I know, but I believe in you and me. True love don't die. Thank you. I want to say a special thank you to Creative Saskatchewan for getting behind this project to so we could do this every second week all throughout the winter months. Our next show is going to be coming up on February the 3rd from the Rochdale Roca House. And I also want to bring special attention to Brewed Awakenings here. This is our new home for the next couple months. And I want to thank Lisa and Ken McMurchie for opening the doors. The business is not actually open at night here. They've just let us use their wonderful space. It's got a really cool atmosphere in here. And if you're ever around Dewdney Avenue or any of the Brewed Awakenings locations, stop in and have a coffee. It's pretty good. That song was about finding true love. And this next one here is written for my true love. And I've told this story a bunch of different times, and I more or less keep it relatively close to the truth. It sometimes morphs a little bit, but I won't get too deep in the story. This one, this was a co-write I did with Dave Wasserloo from Doc Walker. And it was basically a write this song to get out of the doghouse was the situation. I drove to Winnipeg and I didn't know if I would have a house to come home to. And we wrote furiously for the next 3 days. And after day two, I think she started responding to my text messages. And then I sent her a work tape of the song. And then we started talking again, and the rest is history. And I haven't been in many long-term serious relationships, but the one thing that I have learned in this one is it's never too late to say you're sorry, and even though you may put your foot in your mouth, you can always pull it out, and if you're willing to work at it. This is called The Kind of Man. Step at a time. I wanna be the sparkle in your eye. Wanna be the magic in your life. Wanna be your everything. That's the kind of man that I wanna be. Yeah, that's the kind of man that I'm gonna be. I don't always do right by you. I've done things I can't undo. But darling, there's still good inside my heart. And I know my insecurities, they sometimes get the best of me. It's so hard to find my way out of the dark, out of the dark. Oh, I know I've got a long, long way to go. I'm gonna make my way one step at a time. Sparkle in your eye. Wanna be the magic in your life. I wanna be your everything. That's the kind of man that I wanna be. Yeah, that's the kind of man that I'm gonna be. Ha! landslides and tidal waves. Against all odds, baby, here we are. Never have made it on my own. It's the strongest love I've ever known. I know I'm a better man in your arms. Back in your arms. Oh, I know I still got a long, long way to go. I'm gonna make my way one step at a time. I wanna be the sparkle in your eye. I wanna be the magic in your life. I wanna be your everything. That's the kind of man that I wanna be. Yeah, damn it, that's the man gonna be. That's for my girl Tammy. Thank you. I think I got time to do about two more songs. I want to thank the man behind all the controls, the Wizard of Oz. Brent Nielsen is running cameras, doing sound, looking after everything, streaming. Thanks a lot, Brent. And of course, my girl Tammy, who helps me set up and tear down and helps me design the set to make sure everything works. Thank you, dear. And my good friend Angela Harris, who's working the chat room online from all the way out on the left coast. Good evening, Angela. Thanks for helping us out with the project. I'm thinking about sending another song out to radio here next month. I'm going to play it for you here tonight. I want to do this one for my buddy Rob Thompson. We grew up together. And this song is about the bullying question. I don't know if there's any, I don't think there's a simple answer to ending bullying. I don't know if there's a way to ever end bullying. I think it's just a shitty thing that human beings do to each other. But I think talking about it is a good step, and this one here is called Black and Blue. He don't take the short way home. The bell rings after school. Different route every day. Survival is the rule. Sometimes it's out behind the monkey bars, or that spot behind the gym. A time or two stood his ground, they caught up to him. It's that same old Elvis feeling, just another day. He don't see an ending. Amy's gotta play, that's what you do when you grow up black and blue. Look him in the eye and tell him things are gonna change. When you know too well around here it's always been this way. But when you brew so deep you just can't help but learn. Take your turn. Now these days things are different, and he's got all the friends. He's filled out, he's found his voice, now they don't mess with him. Now he's the star out on the football field, and the big guy in the gym. When that bell rings, I do my best to not run into him. It's that same old Elvis feeling, just another day. another generation. Oh, no, no other way, that's what you do when you grow up black and blue. Look him in the eye and tell him things are gonna change. When you know too well around here it's always been this way. When you brew so deep you just can't help but learn. You wait your turn, that's what you do when you grow up black and blue. Tell him things are gonna change. When you know too well around here it's always been this way. When you brew so deep you just can't help but learn. You take your turn, it's nothing new when you grow up black and blue. A tough pill to chew, grow up black and blue. Just what you do when you grow up black and blue. I wrote that with my friend Dean Cush. And stay tuned for my next show on February 3rd. Dean is going to be my special guest. He was the front man and the founder of Faster Gun, and I'm really excited to have him join me because we do a fair bit of co-writing together, and I haven't seen the guy for probably 3 or 4 months now, so I'm looking forward to it. Thanks again for tuning in, and again to the Last Birds, you were fantastic, and you guys have a great week ahead of you. Stay safe, and I'm going to do this one for my nephew Neil. It's called It's a Pride Thing. Turning dirt all day on a worn-out plow, making the bales by the sweat of his brow. But he sleeps real good when he lays down at night. Now he don't make much, so he lives real lean. His hands are dirty, but the money's clean. And there's something about standing on your own. Well, this ain't no story about chasing dreams. Ain't about reaching for the big brass ring. It's about working for what you need. Oh, it's a pride thing. At a checkout counter on her feet all day. It's a dead-end job, but you don't complain. With the kid at home, you do what you gotta do. Shopping for clothes at the second-hand store. It ain't a mouth bogey to making sure that they've always got enough to get them through. This ain't no story about chasing dreams. It ain't about reaching for the big brass ring. It's about working for what you need. You know what I mean. Yeah, it's a pride thing. Picks you up. He's working 14 years down a nickel mine. Wasn't exactly what he had in mind, but when the shift is done, he leaves it all behind. He's got a beautiful girl and a couple of kids. He's their world and they're his. It ain't a little thing when you've got peace of mind. Well, this ain't no story about chasing dreams. Ain't about reaching for the big brass ring. It's about working for what you need. You know what I mean. This ain't no song about chasing dreams, and it ain't about reaching out for big brass rings. It's about working for what you need. You know what I mean. Yeah, it's a pride thing. Yeah, it's a pride thing. Thanks for tuning in to Live and Local. Have a great night.
Ooh, I got you.